this is Kira Anai Matthews, and she's about 7 weeks old, and yeah, full little tummy with breast milk, and her hair is growing longer. She's getting bigger cheeks, bigger thighs, so she's awesome. She's awesome. I've heard some great things about breastfeeding. I believe in it. I think it does work for children, mentally, physically, emotionally, in every sense. It really does work for them. My favorite part is just having that intimate time, that connection, looking into her eyes as she's looking up at me now that she's keeping her eyes open longer, because when she was a newbie, she'd close them, you know, and I couldn't see her eyes, but now I'm looking into her eyes and they're dark gray. I know they're not going to stay like that, but she's gorgeous. Just to have that intimate moment with her and just holding her and feel her suctioning and seeing her gain weight and only on breast milk, it's amazing. Well, it makes me feel great that I'm her source of nutrition, that I'm her lifeline. So it's also very convenient. I don't have to heat up bottles and measure things and, you know, worry about whether or not I'm giving her the right amount. She stops feeding when she's comfortable, and my body just keeps making her food. It's what she needs. I feel awesome. I feel like a leader.
What we have in the way of support in the WIC program and here at the Ryan Center is that we have breastfeeding peer counselors here at the ready, just to help our moms with any latching on problems or just to educate them on how many times they need to feed the baby, especially within the first few weeks, to really establish their milk supply and to not worry whether or not they have enough milk. We reassure them just with other signs that the babies are giving that they do have plenty of milk. So our role is to really reassure these moms from day one. And actually, even when they're still pregnant, we start talking about breastfeeding. We talk about your rights in the hospital regarding breastfeeding your baby, so that you have plenty of opportunity to nurse the baby and latch the baby on even before you go home and in the first few hours and days that you're home.
I started breastfeeding 23 years ago. That was my first experience. I remember having my baby. It was given to me. And back then, there was really not an option. They would give formula either way. They would not ask you, are you going to breastfeed, or would you like to have your baby take formula? I remember giving birth. I was taken to my room. And 2 hours later, my baby comes into the room, and the nurse comes with a bottle with formula. I remember holding my baby, and I was ready to feed him. And I had that first smell of formulas. This is a habit I have of opening things and smelling them. And thank God for that. I opened the bottle, I smelled it. I was like, this doesn't smell right. And I said, well, maybe I can try to breastfeed. And I did, and I love it, and it was a connection right away. 15 years later, I ended up having my second child, London, and there was no option right there. I knew I wanted to breastfeed, but I tended to have some issues. I had hypothyroidism. I was diagnosed with it at my 7th month of pregnancy, and I didn't have a very supportive team. Doctors were telling me that there was not an option to breastfeed, that once I had my baby, I would start my medication. And I thought otherwise. I said I was going to take my chances and I was going to breastfeed. And I did. My daughter got her colostrum and I fed my daughter for 6 months. A lot of moms really don't know about this because you think WIC, you think formula right away. You don't see that they might be able to support you with breastfeeding. I was a little disappointed at the time because if I would have known and I would have walked through those doors with Ryan earlier, I probably would have not gone through what I went through during my experience in breastfeeding my second time, because my first time was such a beautiful experience. I thought the second time was gonna be the same. And that's one of the reasons that I decided I was going to volunteer, come to Ryan's, and help other mothers not to go through the same things that I went through. And when they told me that I can come in and get educated and become a peer counselor, I jumped to the chance. I said, I'm going to help others so others will have the same experience as I did. And I'm very grateful for that, because I can always give.
My main role is to educate women on the benefits of breastfeeding and also direct them to our breastfeeding exam room. In the exam room, they are free to breastfeed. I can label it in ECW where they are, if the doctor needs them or the nurse. I always help them find it, I help them locate it, and I help them direct them also to WIC services as well, the Rhine Women and Children's Center.
I breastfed my daughter for almost 4 years. My experience in the beginning was not so good, and I guess, you know, part of the work I do is, you know, taking my experiences and sharing it with the community. Especially now, it's so important to tell women that everyone's experience is different. I don't think that people have the same experiences. And part of what I do is letting women know that it's okay. You know, you're doing a great job. At the end of the day, whatever you choose, if you choose to breastfeed 1 month or 4 years, it's totally up to you. And you did the best that you could. What we do here is make sure that women don't feel like they didn't achieve their goal. The goal here is to make sure that women feel at ease and know what they're going to be faced with.
What a lot of people don't realize is that breastfeeding, there are tons of benefits to baby, but there are also tons of benefits to mom that are often overlooked. So some of these include the hormone prolactin, which is the milk-making hormone, actually provides a calming effect to mom, so it can be very relaxing. So milk production, actually, you expend 200 to 500 calories a day. So over the course of the week, that can equate to a pound, which is roughly 3,500 calories. So this is a huge bonus to mom getting back to her pre-pregnancy body. Oxytocin is actually, not only does it help mom and baby bond, but it also helps the uterus contract back to pre-pregnancy size.
So I have a 7-month-old daughter. She's my first baby, and I have been breastfeeding her the whole time. It's difficult. It's difficult to continue breastfeeding and working, but I have to say, when I first started breastfeeding, I just cried and cried and cried. I thought, oh, I can't do this. I just can't. And I pushed through it, and I can't tell you how happy I am that I did it. It's just wonderful, because I don't like pumping at work because it's hard and it takes time out of your day, but when I get home, it's that time that she and I can spend together, and there's just nothing better than that, is to get home at the end of the day and be able to nurse her and cuddle with her and spend that time.
Besides giving advice to all my patients, I also trying to encourage people to breastfeed, and I have a very good example and good experience for myself. I have 3 children. My youngest one is 16 months old. Excuse me, I'm still breastfeeding. All of my kids mostly were exclusively breastfeeding babies. I really believe in breast milk. I think this is the best ever you can do for your child. I always keep saying there's 2 investments for your child. One of them is breastfeeding, another one is education. The rest is not important in this life, besides health, of course. But again, breast milk is one of the foundation for the health status, right? I do donate my milk to a lot of babies. I do have believe it or not, I have a big list of moms who...
One of the first babies I donate my breast milk, she's almost the age of my 3rd child. I live in New Jersey, and she was coming from PA twice a month. I should tell you that I used to produce, believe it or not, close to 100 ounces a day. Then I was producing up to 80, and now I'm producing up to 60 ounces a day. So I still donate my breast milk. One of the baby I have, she was very premature. She was giving birth to the baby 24 weeks of gestational age. Another baby I have right now, she is 17 months old. She, unfortunately, she has a Down syndrome and she doesn't really gain well. And I recently received an email from the mom. She started gaining weight from my breast milk. So I'm very happy and very proud of this story.
One of the first things would be actually complimenting her on that. You know, she's doing a good job. Secondly, you could help out by burping the baby or changing the diapers. Also, giving her a little time out, either a little nap time, and you can take care of the child. Or you could let her go out while you stay home taking care of the baby. So you're gonna want to encourage the mom by letting her know that she's doing the best thing for the baby, for their baby, by breastfeeding. Also by ignoring all the negative comments that come from the breastfeeding, to let her know that she's doing everything positively right, and that's what she's doing is actually best for the child in the future.
So in addition to breastfeeding, I also pump. And that allows my fiance to breastfeed her. We often make jokes like that because when he's doing tummy time on his chest, she's like bouncing and looking for the chest. And she's like, I wish, but I can't. So he gets tummy time with her and just intimate time with her as well when he gets to bottle feed her. And she's looking into his eyes and, you know, so it's awesome.
Oh, well, it's really nice because I think that you get like even closer with them. Because when I breastfeed, I talk to her, you know, and I think that she listened to me, even though I don't know if she does, but I like it. I like it. And I feel that for her, for health, is very good and all the stuff, so. And I was surprised when she was born and they gave it to me just right away. She just went right to my nipple, my first baby. It was like after the second or the third day that he went because he didn't want to and he wasn't, you know. But the hair was like right away. She just went right to the nipple and she started eating right there. I mean, it was painful, but when you see the face and everything, it's like you don't feel. I mean, like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I think that everything to breastfeeding is. It's great and have good things, you know. So what I can say is I hear moms that they don't want to breastfeed it because, you know, the breasts that get down and all the stuff. But I say that stuff doesn't matter, you know. Once that you have your child and you know that it's good for them, you just have to do the best for them. So like, I have a friend that she didn't want to and she didn't breastfeed the kid because of that. And, you know, I don't know, for them, it's I think it's the best, you know, breastfeeding. And then after that, well, we can drink bottles.
The reason why I decided to breastfeed is when I found out I was carrying twins. I knew it would be the best choice for me and for the babies. For me, because financially, it would be much more worthwhile than to purchase milk formula. And for the babies, because they will be healthier and it would be a good way for me to bond with two babies at the same time. Life was going to be chaotic and I had to deal with all the hurdles that I've heard about, time consuming, whether I'd produce milk or not. And turns out that if you have milk, you can make more milk. And it was no problem with having smaller breasts. I had enough milk for two babies and it lasted 2 years, and that was the biggest hurdle for me, was overcoming the fact that I had in my head that I couldn't breastfeed two babies for so long. I spoke with friends who were pregnant at the time, and those who didn't think it was possible, they ended up breastfeeding their own child for more than 2 years though, so they surpassed me. And with all this experience and seeing my baby looking at me breastfeeding was the best feeling in the world. You can never take your eyes off your baby smiling at you and while you're breastfeeding them. I decided to become a peer counselor and share my experience with moms. And it's been great. Many moms who had no support at home found support when I was when I kept contact with them prior to them giving birth and during the whole birthing process at the hospital. A lot of them, I was able to speak to them on the phone, and they were so happy I called them then. When they went home, if they had issues, we spoke about it, and it was great. And they're still breastfeeding at this time, and it was great for me. It took away the time to wash bottles. It took away the time, you know, carrying bottles with you everywhere you went, and having the stress that maybe I'm not gonna have enough milk out there with me. And I always carried my milk with me, and was no time at all breastfeeding, because they would breastfeed in 10 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes, and they're full, they fall asleep. At nighttime, you just lay down and you breastfeed your baby and you fall asleep together. It was the best as far as time is concerned for me. Saved me a lot of time, saved me a lot of money, and my breasts were enough. My baby makes me feel ecstatic, and my kids are healthy, they're so smart, and I know it's because of breastfeeding. Those early brain connections that breast milk enhances for your baby, I know that's why my daughters are so smart today.
And then I have another one that lasted the longest, and that was for 6 months. And she was holding on strong. I didn't like formula at all, not even to leave her at home when I went to school. Did not happen. Breastfed while I was in school. And then I stopped because I found out I had conceived my son. So then he breastfed as well, but he breastfed only for a month and a half. And for some reason, I just wouldn't lactate as much. So I just started him on formula, but for Nova's case, I had to stop because they said that my cholesterol was too high. And they said that it was so high that they had to start medication, but they never did. So that sucked.
Yeah.
But she did good. It was a little struggle.
Go.
But she's pretty healthy apart from having to stop suddenly, which hurt really, really bad. Because it was so sudden. So I taped her down little by little by switching out with the water gun. But she's pretty good. I felt I got kind of like shortage in the bond with her. Like, I bonded with her very great, but then I felt like I wasn't giving her what she really wanted. And that was kind of depressing. Look at her now. But she's doing great. And then after the first month, she actually just stood with the formula, which was perfect. I was scared about nutrition as well. But other than that, she's healthy.
My daughter's 3. I breastfed her from birth. It was awesome. I think she was born to breastfeed. As soon as I gave birth to her, actually a midwife, she came and she was like, I was nervous because my oldest, I never breastfed. It hurt and I didn't do it. So the second one, I was like really excited to try it and do it. And it saved money. She put it right on it and they said like they know. So she actually, as soon as she came out, she put it right on me and she went right to my breast. Didn't, no diet, no prompting, no nothing. She went right to it. And she was like a natural sucker. I had no problems with her breastfeeding, so it was awesome. It was a very good experience. Bonding was awesome. It's good for late nights. The late night feeders just get up and just let her lay there, and we just lay in there. It was really nice. The bonding, she hardly got sick, which was true. That I did see that was a big difference. She gained a lot of weight. She was a little teeny tiny thing to the breastfeeding. She gained a lot of weight. Still healthy, but she just gained a lot of weight. And I'm glad I got to experience it. Had some little trials and tribulations, try to figure out, you know, the best position sometimes, or her actually latching was one of my problems. But I had some friends who helped, and I read up, and they gave videos, so I was able to get it together. But it was a very good experience. I'm glad I did it. I wouldn't change anything. I wish I could have breastfed him a little longer, but coming back to work was kind of a pumping, and I work in a school, so pumping was kind of hard to kind of get that time to pump, so it was kind of hard. But I did make it to 6 months, so I was very proud of myself for the 6 months. And that's my story.
The first piece of advice I always give new moms is that it's going to be tough. It's not easy to breastfeed, especially your first baby. Things get a lot easier with the other babies, but the first one, it's hard. The baby's learning, you're learning. But I'm so glad that I stuck it out. And if I can convince anybody else to do it, if you can do it, it's totally worth it and so rewarding. When I had her, and I think it's tough when anybody has the first baby, and I'm sitting there and just crying, and you know, it was uncomfortable, and your body is changing, and you have this new baby, and everybody was saying, well, why don't you just give a formula? You know, it'll be easier, it'll, you know, it's fine, you're so, you know, it seems really hard. And I was almost on the brink. I think about a day away from doing it. And I'm just glad I didn't. But on the other hand, you know, I just want other moms to know that we all feel this way. There's nobody that goes home with this amazing baby that just latches right on and you have no discomfort, and it's so simple. Everybody's learning. Everybody, it's a steep learning curve, but it's totally worth it. But moms, you aren't alone. Actually, I have had a patient that was breastfeeding and then stopped because she was sick and she couldn't breastfeed anymore, and she so missed it, but she actually restarted breastfeeding from scratch. Like, she had just had to take the baby and put her to the breast and nurse until she reestablished her milk supply. And it took probably a month, but it was incredible. She, you know, she really, really had to work at it, and God bless that baby. The baby had to work at it too. But by the end of the month, they'd actually reestablished breastfeeding.
I think it's a really wonderful experience, both for the children and for yourself. From a very practical perspective, I can't imagine not breastfeeding. It makes one's life very easy. Mm-hmm. You don't deal with bottles, you don't deal with, you can come, you can go. Mm-hmm. Certainly when you're working, there is a need to express milk to leave it, because I did not supplement. So, you know, you express the milk, but that's easy once your milk comes in. It's not a hard thing to do. And again, the freedom you get by being able to travel with your kids and not have to worry about, do I have a bottle? Do I have what I need? Things to clean up. None of it's there. And so from a very practical perspective, I don't understand why folks choose not to. I think it really helps in very early bonding with kids. Not to say that you don't bond with your children if you're not nursing, but I think that early kind of touching and nurturing is a wonderful way to kind of bond with a child non-verbally. It also helps mom to slow down. You know, there's advice that we give parents all the time, which is, particularly in those early days, when the child sleeps, you sleep. Well, one of the nice things about nursing is, even if you don't sleep when your child sleeps, when you're nursing, you're totally relaxed. That's kind of the activity you're involved in. And so again, you're very present for your child and for yourself. So I think that's a really wonderful thing to do. They had very few days off because of illness. Didn't have lots of early infections and those kinds of things. Good genetics, a little breastfeeding, you know, a lot of things go into that. But I certainly think that it's there. And that's the thing that I think that people really need to keep in mind. It's instinctual. Kids suck. And they latch on. And the hardest part of it is at least for me, you know, is the first couple of days when your nipple is getting a little hardened and doesn't respond to the suction in the same kind of way. Because the first couple of days can sometimes be a little painful. It's all worth it. You know, if you're verbal, if you're there, if you say to somebody, this is what I want, now you can say, and can I see the breastfeeding consultant on your floor? Because every hospital now has somebody designated to provide that. those early problems, whatever they can be, they are for a woman, can be addressed. And I think you're giving yourself a gift and you're giving your child a gift when you nurse.
There's a lot to know about breastfeeding. And there's a lot of ways that you can help new moms, encourage them, show them, teach them. But it's not something that comes easily, and I think that was really surprising to me. As I went on through my residency, I started to learn about how important breastfeeding is, the incredible benefits. And there are so many benefits to babies and young children in breastfeeding. I mean, what else can you do to help a baby be healthier? I had an attending as a resident who said to me, if you can find an exclusively breastfed baby with a bacterial infection of the bloodstream, I'll give you $100. He goes, because it just doesn't happen. Breastfed babies don't get the same kind of infections that formula fed babies. As a pediatrician, I really try to pass on that information to parents. I think it's so important that moms know the benefits, but that you're also helping moms and coaching them through, and pregnant moms, you're helping them understand there are gonna be some challenges along the way, but if you're really dedicated and committed to it, we're gonna help you find a way to do it.
I have a 13-month-old son, and I am still breastfeeding him. I started out exclusively breastfeeding him for 6 months, and then at 6 months started introducing food, and then continued to breastfeed him since then. The bonding of breastfeeding with your baby is just, it's really special. Anybody who has a one-year-old knows that they are always on the go. They never stop moving. You can't get them to sit still for even 15 minutes. But continuing to nurse him, I have that time with him every day, in the morning, and at night. We sit and we bond, and he's able to sit still during that time, and we nurse, and it's a really special moment between us that we get to have that time together. Going back to work, and so I exclusively breastfed for the first 6 months, but I came back to work when my son was 12 weeks old. So obviously I had to pump at work. It's important to set a specific time for yourself, that this is your time that you're going to pump, and try to stick to that. Try if you can to put aside work for that time and just relax. Think about your baby, bring a picture of your baby if it'll help, and if you just try to focus in on that, it's a lot easier to kind of get things going than if you're trying to pump at work and still think about all the things that you have to do at dinner, answer phone calls. The advice I would give to new moms who haven't breastfed before is two things. First, to be patient. Sometimes it's hard at first. It was hard for me. They always tell you it'll take a couple days for your milk to come in, maybe 3 to 5 days. I was one of those people that it took 5 days. And the other advice I would give is to just set small goals. It can be very daunting, especially when you know that you're only going to have maybe 8 weeks or 10 weeks or maybe even less home with the baby, and then you have to go back to work. You can think to yourself, well, why even bother to start this? Because I know what's coming in the future. And that helped me a lot. At first, I just set a goal to breastfeed for 3 months, and then we'll see what happens when I go back to work. And so I hit that, and then I thought, well, let's just take it a little further and see how far I can go. And then I hit 6 months, and things were still doing well. So I thought, well, let's try for 9. And then things were still going well at 9 months. So I thought, well, maybe I can hit a year. And it's much easier to just set those small one day at a time goals than say to yourself, I have to do this for a certain amount of time. Because really any day, every day that you breastfeed your baby is just one more day to help him or her out. And anything you can do is a benefit.
So not all women have a great support circle, and not all support circles really understand the benefits of breastfeeding. So we find that it's really important for women to have that person that they can go to with questions, concerns, needs. And really my role for these women is to be a support for them and to give them the right information and to help them with strategies that are pertinent to their lifestyle so that they could be as successful as they want when it comes to their breastfeeding goals. Breastfed babies are healthier babies, and we know that. We know that the research shows that. It's something that we've really gotten away from in our society, but it's something that we're really working hard to get moms and families and dads and all caregivers to really understand that mom's milk is meant for mom's baby. And that milk is just perfect. It's going to be just what that baby needs. It's going to give that baby everything from immunology protection to nutrition to grow. And it really just is the best thing for that baby.
And I think as personal, you know, experience, when I had my first baby, you know, the first thing I wanted to do was really have the baby on the breast as soon as possible. And it was a little upsetting because my first baby came premature. So I begged and begged, and you know, once they felt like the baby was really stable, they let me spend those first few minutes with her, but then they whisked her off to the NICU. And I tell this story too because it's so funny. I would visit her in the NICU. She couldn't remember me the first couple of days, but she was doing well. She was 35 weeks, she had a good suck. And they said, here, you need to give her formula. She needs to come out of the NICU, you wanna go home with her. And so I took her into the breastfeeding room and I took the formula and I literally poured it out into the sink. And I was like, I'm not gonna give this baby formula. I'm like, I have to breastfeed. I was crazy, crazy mom, right? But I was like, it's gotta work for me, it's gonna work for me. And it did. There was a few bumps along the road, but I mean, literally the first class I could take in the hospital with the lactation consultant, you know, I was there bright and early. Knocking on her door, calling her, I want you to come in, I want to make sure I'm doing everything right. Because despite all the books, you know, all of the firsthand experience, all the coaching I've done with moms, it still wasn't the same as having the breastfeeding experience. But that breast milk coming out of the pump is like gold, and people will tell you that. If you drop a little, if it spills out, you're like, oh no, no, no. It's terrible because you work so hard for it, and it's so precious. And then a few years after Katie was born, I found out I was pregnant with twins. I got a hospital-grade pump for the first time in my life. Every 2 to 3 hours, I was pumping, and I was putting the babies on the breast as much as I could. Again, like breastfeeding two at once, that's a challenge in itself. It was difficult, to say the least. And once again, I went to my trusty lactation consultant. I went home. I called up another lactation consultant. I said, come and, you know, help me with this. Because I really need a lot of milk. But the babies would really prefer to breastfeed. And it got to a point sometimes when I felt like they were starving because I wasn't getting enough milk. But they would just keep going. And then I would, again, pump as much as I could. And they got a good amount. You know, I breastfed until they were 14 months. And then at that point, you know, they both self-weaned. And that was it for me. But I'll never forget the first time I breastfed my first child, and I'll never forget the last time I breastfed my fourth child. It's just a wonderful, wonderful experience.
Breastfeeding is as good as it gets.